I'm Steve Butler, Vice President of Engineering for VPT. In this video, we'll look at the cross-regulation performance of the DVHF2805D 5-volt dual output converter. The performance is typical of VPT's dual output DC-DC converters. Before we start, one note about the fixture we're using here. To measure the output voltage, it's important to measure the voltage directly at the pins of the DC-DC converter. If you measure at the load, the voltage drop in the load wires will impact the measurement and exhibit poor regulation. To measure correctly at the pins, we use what's called a Kelvin socket or a two-wire connection where the connector has two contacts in each connector. This measures the voltage directly on the pins. So now we'll turn on the power and take a look at the meters. First, we have the positive output voltage, reads 5 volts. The positive output current reads 1.5 amps. The negative output voltage reads negative 5 volts. And the negative output current reads negative 1.5 amps. This is a 15-watt converter. The total load current is 3 amps at 5 volts, and that's split 1.5 amps on the positive and 1.5 amps on the negative. So this is a balanced load condition, full load, 15 watts, and you can see that both the positive and the negative output are very tightly regulated. We can now switch to a no load, but still balanced load condition, so zero load on both outputs. You can see the positive output is still 5.0 volts. The negative output is negative 4.96 volts. So as long as the load is balanced, both outputs are very tightly regulated. In general, the positive output is always tightly regulated. The internal feedback loop of the converter regulates the positive output. So no matter what we do with the loads, I can turn one load on, one load off, and you'll notice on this meter here that this voltage, 4.999, is always tightly regulated. Now I have the load set up for a 70%, 30% split. So this is the condition specified in the data sheet where we specify the cross-regulation. So right now we have 2.1 amps on the positive output and 0.9 amps on the negative output. That adds up to 1.5 amps. That adds up to 3 amps total, and that is still 15 watt full load condition. So in this case, you can see that the negative output goes to minus 5.36 volts. So we call that 360 millivolts of cross regulation, well within the 500 millivolts specified on the data sheet. Now we will reverse the condition. So we will go to 2.1 amps on the negative output and 0.9 amps on the positive output. Notice the positive always stays at 5.0. The negative is now negative 4.64 volts, about 350 millivolts. Cross-regulation, still well within the data sheet. Now we'll take a look at some more extreme loading conditions. We'll observe that the positive output stays regulated, and we'll watch what happens to the negative output. So we have 1.5 volt, which is about half load on the positive output, and we'll first take the negative output down to 10% load, or 0.15 amp. We can see that its voltage goes up to negative 5.75 volts. Now we'll take the negative output all the way to no load, and we'll watch its output climb to minus 6.4 volts. That's about as high as that output will go. It's clamped internally by a Zener diode. By adding some preload on the negative output in this condition, you can limit that voltage further. So now we will go back to a balanced load condition, and now we will drop the load on the positive output. So we've got 1.5 amps on the negative, and we will go to about 10%, 0.15 on the positive. Positive output stays regulated. In this case, the negative output drops to about negative 4.3 volts. So it drops a little farther. Now we will go no load on the positive output. Now in this condition, remember the positive output is regulated and it's with no load, it'll stay at 5 volts, but the duty cycle of the converter will cut back significantly. And the negative output, even though the load is only about 10%, it will not be able to support any voltage. So you do need to maintain some minimum load on the positive output if you expect to get voltage out of the negative output. A couple of things to remember with the dual output converters. If you stay within the 70%, 30% split of the outputs, you will maintain very good regulation on the negative output. Of course, the positive output will always be tightly regulated. If the negative output is completely unloaded, its voltage can increase somewhat. It is clamped internally by a Zener diode, and it can be clamped further with an external Zener or preload. And always maintain about 10% load on the positive output if you plan to use the negative output. Thank you.